sugar challenge.
It's this spoonful of granulated sugar
versus this spoonful of powdered sugar. Which is the sweetest, and who will get the taste the fastest?
One of the cool things about nanotechnology is that really small stuff has more surface area. More surface area means more places for chemical reactions.
Wait, what? If it's really small, how can it have more surface area?
Let me explain. Imagine a cube that's 1 centimeter on each side. It has a surface area that is 6 square centimeters. Remember, surface area is a measure of the total area that is exposed on the outside. So it's not just the top, but also the bottom and the sides. Now, let's keep the volume the same, but divide that cube 10 times along each side into 1 millimeter sized cubes. Then the surface area is 60 square centimeters.
Okay, I know, this is the good part. What if you had smaller pieces that were only 1 nanometer in size?
Let me talk. Take that same cube with the same exact volume. Divide it into 1 nanometer sized cubes. Now the total surface area is 60 million square centimeters. That is definitely more surface area.
It's larger than a football field. Imagine how many more chemical reactions we could create with all that surface area, even though the volume is identical.
So, which sugar has more surface area?
All right, let's do this.
That's sweet. Are you okay?
All that surface area makes the sweetness overwhelming. I mean, I can tell that powdered sugar has way more surface area.
Which means more places for chemical reactions. And that's why highly engineered nanoparticles are the wave of the future. They're already a $1 billion industry.
And can even be used to make batteries that last longer.
And can even be used in shampoo and conditioner to make hair softer.
Surface area nanoparticles sure are a sweet deal.
And that's nanotechnology.